Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is going to be the third video of my personal project, which is effects of distorted urbanization on natural resources. In this video, we are going to talk about the relation between distorted urbanization and Istanbul. The history of distorted urbanization in Istanbul, a little bit cause and effects of distorted urbanization in Istanbul. Is there an architectural culture style in Istanbul? First, let's do a little bit review of my project. Let's summary the whole project. In the first video, I talked about what is urbanization. I talked about me, personal project, IBM IP, effects of distorted urbanization on natural resources. Then I talked about the meaning of urbanization, increasing the proportion of people living in towns and cities, and the connection between overpopulation, economy, and modernization. Then I talked about cause and effects of only urbanization. For causes, I said that social factors such as better quality of living, education facilities, modernization, better technology. For the advantages of urbanization, I said that better economy and education, better social life, better housing. For disadvantages, I said that crowded places, unemployment level, and pollution such as air and noise pollution. And then I talked about the different types of urbanization such as physical urbanization, social urbanization, demographic urbanization, and functional urbanization. And this is the basically what I talked about in the first video. Then I published the second video about distorted urbanization. What is distorted urbanization? What is the relation between shanty houses and distorted urbanization? Then I talked about the main cause and effects of distorted urbanization. And lastly, I talked about how to avoid distorted urbanization. This part is the most important part of my last video because I talked about how to avoid distorted urbanization. This is the summary of my two videos that I published in the last weeks. So let's talk about the relation between Istanbul and urbanization. Distorted urbanization and Istanbul. By the way, my project is going to be done in probably 2 weeks. So that part, which is avoiding distorted urbanization part, is so important for my project because my goal is to inform you. So I would be glad if you check this part of my last video again. So let's talk about the topic of this video, which is relation between urbanization and Istanbul. Let's talk about modernization. What is modernization? Modernization and Istanbul and cause and effects. During the research part of my personal project, I found an online document which is Modernization, Urbanization and Turkey. I'm going to summarize it. Istanbul is a city that modernizes with technology, industrialization, economic and political developments. It is also preferred by a large community because it is a modern, developed city. As I learned from this article, one of the biggest reasons of distorted urbanization is modernization. Because modernization is the orientation of people to cities if they have advanced technology, ease of life and job opportunities. In addition, this naturally causes population growth. Based on this information, problems such as the need of housing, traffic, unemployment, lack of infrastructure, which constitute distorted urbanization. Istanbul is a city that hadn't fully modernized compared to other cities. Economic level of Turkey is less than the level of urbanization, rate of urbanization. Therefore, this situation leads to becoming an unplanned system while the economic system isn't good. Modernization process is called the country's adaptation to developments in places such as technology, economy and industry. In line with certain innovations, modernization is the step taken towards adopting a more modern lifestyle. A country where unplanned urbanization is of great importance and cannot find a solution during the process of modernization, the most important of these problems is some economic problems arising from lack of planning. This is the mainly relation between modernization and Istanbul. I write the cause and effects of modernization related with distorted urbanization, but I'm not going to talk detailed about it because I talked about in both my first video and second video. Istanbul has a distorted urbanization problem, and the reasons for that situation is basically the population growth in 1950 years and also the migration to the city. And also uncontrollable power due to the increase in shanty houses and urbanization are among the causes of distorted urbanization. Let's talk a little bit of results of urbanization related with modernization. There is the needs of houses, the increase in the number of shanty houses, increase in the number of illegal and unstable structures, and the inability to control all these can be given for effects. In addition, the increase in concrete together with the need for housing and the damage to the natural structure can be shown as example of the results. Let's talk about the history of Istanbul, the history of the distorted urbanization in Istanbul. How urbanization becomes distorted urbanization in Istanbul? While the population in Istanbul was 1 million at the beginning of 1900, it decreased to 690,000 in 1920. In 1935, this number reached 740,000 and immediately followed. Later, due to migration in the 1950s, urbanization and shanty houses came to the fore in this period. With the urbanization rate, the rate of shanty houses has increased so much. The number of illegal buildings was 240,000 in 1960. Apart from the 1960 years, with the increase in shanty houses, started. In the 1970 years, the rapid population growth and the basic needs such as housing and transportation increased. In this case, as I mentioned in my previous blog post, the action of shanty settlements developed greatly. Also, with the increasing population in the 1970 years, the number of automobiles increased and caused an increase in traffic and air pollution, such as also noise pollution. Then in 1970s, it was decided to build a bridge connecting Europe and Asia for a solution to transportation problem. With this decision, a significant solution has been found for transportation. With the help of transportation, the number of buses increased with the increasing population, and then Istanbul started to become a busy city. Finally, with the opening of the Boğaziçi Bridge in 1973, transportation in Europe and Asia has become quite relaxed. However, the development activities have also increased. In this way, the number of shanty houses has increased and Istanbul become a distorted urban city. This problem goes to till these days, and distorted urbanization becomes a big problem in Istanbul. Let's talk about the architectural style of Istanbul. In my last video, I said that most of distorted urbanization is not a problem of architects or construction companies because of the published contract rule. I just want to give some information about the history of architectural style in Istanbul. Shanty towns gained an uncontrollable power, and Istanbul developed in a distorted way. Developments in technology, industrialization, trade, education, health and politics affect on Istanbul to be more busy, comfortable and convenient in terms of ease of life. In this direction, the need for housing and especially the need for transportation has increased. Structures that carry very important architectural cultures in Istanbul, such as Galata Tower, Ayasofya, can be given as examples. As we can see on the internet, these structures, which were designed by very important architects, for example, Mimar Sinan, generally, if we look at the history of these buildings and in generally, were designed by considering Byzantine architecture, Islamic architecture, Romanesque architecture,
In fact,
there is an architectural culture and style. However, with the time, the development of technology, the rapid population growth and the old need for housing, the old architectural style of Istanbul has not been addressed. With the developing technology, buildings in the style of modern architecture started to be designed. Unfortunately, today, no work is done to preserve the historical architectural culture and architectural style of Istanbul. Sort of urbanization damages the natural, cultural and architectural style of the city. For these reasons, the new architectural structures of Istanbul, which has developed in a distorted way, are not designed in accordance with any historical architectural culture of Istanbul. The biggest reason for this is the uncontrollable development of the housing need arising due to uncontrollable power. Result, the architecture of Istanbul today shows an extremely uncontrolled development. Is that Istanbul today doesn't carry a historical architectural culture, actually in new buildings. We can see that before, in past, there is an architectural culture, architectural style in Istanbul, but now, in new buildings, there is no architectural style. We can see modern architectural system in new buildings, and that affects on our story of architectural style so much. So let's talk about the relation with mainly Istanbul. Detail this sentence. Istanbul is a very crowded place. In this direction, it is possible to see distorted urbanization in many places. I mentioned in here in both Asian and European side, when the busiest, most crowded places in Istanbul with the best business opportunities are places such as Kağıthane, Diyar, Maslak, Beşiktaş in European side of Istanbul. The busiest place in Istanbul is Beşiktaş. As a matter of fact, increasing population and the housing need arising from the selection of such regions to live, many of these buildings are illegally built. Moreover, it is not designed by taking the architectural culture that I mentioned before. Istanbul is among the places where distorted urbanization is mostly seen due to reasons such as the fact that such places are busy. They are preferred for life and their ease of life is better. I would like to give additional information that these regions of Istanbul that I mentioned are at the level that of Istanbul because the headquarters of many companies and organizations are located in these places. Istanbul Metropolitan Municipality is also located in these places. To give an example from the Asian side, Ataşehir, Kadıköy, Fikirtepe, Maltepe, we can see in the news that most of the forests in Maltepe are open to the zoning plan. The number of skyscrapers in there is doubling. The urban transformation that has been going on for the last few years in Kadıköy and Fikirtepe is taking a new dimension. In this direction, it can be concluded that the places with the highest population in Istanbul are the most prepared with the most job opportunities, therefore preferred by construction companies. For this reason, urbanization in the regions develops very rapidly and at the same time in a distorted way. In this direction, I wanted to share a news I found during this project research process. The project is Maslak 1453 in Turkish Maslak 1453 projesi. If you are living in Istanbul, it is a project that wasn't off the agenda in the news. If you ask why, the project called Maslak 1453 contains many skyscrapers built on the zone opening of the Fatih Forest, also Belgrad Forest. On the European side of Istanbul. This project, which is constantly on the internet, has emerged. A large part of the Belgrade Forest has been approved for the planning plan and approximately 3,000 trees have been cut down for the construction of this project. With this project, we can see that the sentence that I have repeatedly stated during the urbanization process in Istanbul is that natural resources are ignored, concreting is increased, and many photos of that project on the internet. According to that, what is the biggest problem in Istanbul? As you know, there are so many problems in Istanbul. So crowded places, a lot of noise pollution, a lot of air pollution, too much constructions, security, excessive traffic, increase in the unemployment rate, security issue, the most important, the decrease in the green areas, places. All these problems I mentioned are being complained by each person who lives in Istanbul. Reasons such as ease of life also turns out much more ahead of other cities in Turkey. I'm going to connect these problems with my project. Problems such as crowded places, noise, traffic and security are caused by the rapidly increasing population. Problems such as the decreasing green areas, construction, also the problems that arise due to the inability to meet the housing need and the inability to control the city in this regard. Distorted urbanization, and it should be reminded once again that the city reaches an uncontrollable power due to reasons such as population growth. Of all the concepts that I have explained, the causes and consequences of distorted urbanization, advantages and disadvantages, are somehow related to these problems. For example, as the population increases, the need for housing increases, automobiles increase, noise and traffic and air pollution occurs, and if this is not controlled, it develops in a distorted way. This is the connection between these two situations. For all these reasons, the inability to prevent distorted development is at the top of the biggest problem of Istanbul. If distorted development can be prevented, no problem will be completely eliminated. But we will achieve a planned and most importantly sustainable life. So this is mainly the relation between the problems of Istanbul and my project. Can avoid this situation. Distorted urbanization problem is really big in Istanbul. We can't eliminate it, but we can avoid and we can get a planned system. So yes, this is the one of the videos that related with my project topic. Talked about urbanization, distorted urbanization, relation between Istanbul and distorted urbanization, and in the next video I am going to talk about my topic. One, distorted urbanization, Istanbul related with natural resources. In this video I talked about one of the references that I learned some new information on the researching process of this personal project. I talked about what is modernization, what is architectural style, what is also the history of urbanization, Architect Sinan, Galata Tower, Boğaziçi Bridge. So this is mainly what is my project is. So I just want to inform you about these mainly situations. This is the end of this video. Write the reference part of my project in the explanation part of this video. Also, as I explained in my social accounts, preparing video is not my only project. Blogger. I'm also writing blog posts on Blogger, which is distorted urbanization cinarerkol.blogspot.com. Directly proportional with this video, I publish some new blog posts on that website too. Give some extra informations about the videos. Posting photos on my Instagram account, which is Project of Duist. You can follow this Instagram account with this code. Just showing this code to your Instagram camera will be enough to visit my Instagram account. I'll be so glad if you comment, like and share my Instagram account and also blogger page, blogspot page. So, again and again, thanks for listening to me. See you till the next video as soon as possible.